when the farmer productivity is improved, two things happen. He has enough food to eat, he has enough to make income, and his livelihood will definitely meet improvements. And this is our dream, that Nigeria will produce food beyond self-sufficiency. The research institutes are working hard, developing new varieties, giving good agricultural practices. But then, one other thing is key factor, quality inputs. You have good seeds, you don't have a good fertilizer, you kill the seed. You have good fertilizer, you don't have good seeds. What would the fertilizer yield goods? No. You need both to grow together.
There is no specific fertilizer recommendation for tomato in the country. The farmer is what we can say blanket, but with this project, there will be specific fertilizer recommendation for each location. Then, knowing a specific fertilizer recommendation for each location, it will address the problem of low yield. Then another specific tomato problem that may arise, which has been addressed by this institution. It was in 2015. We call it tuta absoluta. In fact, people call it tomato Ebola because it nearly grounded tomato industry in this country to a halt. But through the intervention of the FAO and the federal government, we have been able to prefer solution. We have physical method. For instance, we develop tomato tuta tree. Then presently we have three developed by the institute. We have Nihot Liptor, Nihot Ractin, and Nihot Liptin. These are materials that are available locally. They are biopesticide. They are safe in terms of synthetic, which is not even solving the problem, and the price is also high. But this one, the pesticides, you know, the materials are produced, are available locally, and it has reduced price to the farmers. Farmers can avoid it easily.
But if you see the land acreage covered by Nigeria is even higher than Egypt, which is the highest producer of tomato in Africa. Well, the missing link is good agricultural practices, which we cannot remove fertilizer. Before this time, the production of tomato had been 1.8, getting towards 2.3 million tons. And as Abeja said, Nigeria is having higher land coverage than Egypt, but the difference is in management strategies, which we want to address through the funding of OCP.
Presently, the essence of this study is for us to get tomato pepper specific fertilizers. And what necessitated this study is that we use generic fertilizers, all weather fertilizer, if I may say. And that cannot give us good yield. Fertilizer should be specific to the crop and to the soil. Therefore, this study is aimed at producing that fertilizer that is specific to Nigerian soils and specific to tomato and pepper production in Nigeria. That is a clarification. Now, on the other side to your question, which is the best? Well, for now in Nigeria, we use NPK, and NPK is generic. As a matter of fact, in some cases, it's degrading the soils by acidifying it in some cases. And what we will advise will still be tomato-specific fertilizer for Nigeria. That will still be the best fertilizer. In the interim, farmers use all kinds of fertilizers. But we hope that the output of this research work would give us a fertilizer, the type of fertilizer that the crop needs and that is suitable to our environment. Most of the time, the other option is to use what we call integrated soil fertility management, where you combine both organic, inorganic fertilizers, as the case may be. But whatever is to be done should be based on soil tests. You don't just dump fertilizers on the soil. When you do that, you create issues of public health concern. But with a good soil test, we'll be able to calculate and then do precision agriculture, giving the soil what it needs and the crop also what it needs.
We will have great potentials. All we need is to agree to utilize our potentials. This is the right food for the right direction. And I implore you farmers to key in into this project. Let other farmers know about it within and outside Uganda. It's not for farmers in Uganda, but it's farmers in Nigeria.
Look at tomato for N. 2.5 to 3 kg, and as others we can see on the screen. We move to the second slide that talks about nutrient absorption. There is an emphasis here. Look at the first line that talks about night. There is a reason I emphasize that, because from literature it's been found that 28 to 45% of total nutrient uptake by plant actually occurs in the night. This is according to Sasuda et al. 1990. And that pea is the most absorbed plant in the night. That is the second slide which I want us to take note of.
I think this workshop is addressing the climatic condition that we are into and the variability of soil that we have. And I think this workshop is really addressing it, and it's a warm place that I really want to get a solution from, which I'm getting the feedback right.
If you take your tissue to the field, to the lab, and they give you results that says 0.001 in the leaf, what is telling you is that that's your plant, that your field is not fertile. I think to put it in a very simple way. If you go there and they give you phosphorus less than 0.015, what does it mean? Not okay. But if you now go to the field and you find soil value 60 phosphorus, what is it telling you? Too much. Don't apply another fertilizer.
There are three things we have to look at. The first is the reagents that we use. They must be analog grade. Analog grade is 99.9% pure. So what it means simply for either a soil fertility testing or a soil chemist is you have eliminated the first error that can come in your result you are getting. If it is not analog grade, there's a likelihood that the result you get is not a true picture of what you get. Equipment that we use. The equipment must be well calibrated and standardized. For example, your AAS, if you don't have a sound technology, I use the word sound, sound and trained, anything you put in AAS will read for you, will put black, it will read it for you. But it needs to be calibrated at every point in time so that an experienced technical staff under the opinion of the scientists will know whether the results you are getting is proper or not, because it is going to be garbage in, garbage out. So we have to make sure that all the equipment we use are up to date, and I hope that is also all right.
Government has institutions on ground. One of them is this NIHOT. And I must tell you, NIHOT has been up and drained. It's one of the foremost agri-research institutes that will be helping farmers. They give us land to cultivate. They give us training here every now and then. We do partnership with them on production of seeds and others. Look, government has been, I should know because I'm fully involved. But then again, we can always ask for more, especially irrigation. That is what we are facing on production of vegetable produce. Otherwise, we should have been doing this 24/7 activity. So we need, of course, we don't expect institutes like NIHO to do that, but Federal Minister of Agri should give us pumping machines, probably at subsidized prices, then seeds and what have you. So these are the ways they can come in.